When we present you a new special operation, we share lots of novelties, features, and lore twists. There are so many of them in the new mission that for the first time ever since I started shooting developer diaries, I have made a note of all the details that should be mentioned. Let's get it started. We are introducing a new mind-blowing special operation, codenamed Blackwood. The mission will take place in Iceland. It is a unique location, completely different from all the settings we have seen in Warface. It has cool visuals, gloomy black cliffs, the sea, and an unusual horizon. In my opinion, it was a very good choice of the visual style by our team. The Blackwood Special Operation develops the storyline of the Vega 5 squad. As you remember, this unit was taken captive at the end of the mission on Mars. After that, we took a side path and created the Special Operation Hydra, where we played for the Sigma unit composed of three players. Now, it's time to return to the squad that we haven't seen since after the end of the mission on Mars and learn what happened to them. After Omega Black took the fighters captive, the soldiers were convinced or forced by torture to fight on the side of Blackwood. So for the first time ever in the history of Warface Special Operations, you will not fight as Warface against Blackwood, but rather as Blackwood against Warface. This is the first cool feature of the new special operation. Basically, you will fight on the side of the bad guys, so to speak. And it's great. Your enemies will change, and you will fight against different kinds of opponents. And naturally, completely different people will come to your aid in this operation. You are in for a non-linear mission on the side of Blackwood forces, and it offers a changing order of completion. You will be deployed on a volcanic island in the northern Atlantic Ocean, where the Blackwood bases that have been captured by Warface troops are located. In total, there are three bases on the island. Basically, they are transmission units for controlling SEVs. Players will have to successfully capture these bases, gather resources in their vicinity, and erect defensive fortifications. In this operation, the fundamental gameplay feature will be the separation of the team into two groups. The first group operating the SEVs will have to eliminate Blackwood Innovation prototypes to prevent them from falling into the hands of Warface. Meanwhile, the second group will defend the terminal at the base and their comrades connected to the said link units. If the terminal gets destroyed, the mission will be failed. Each base will have unique defense mechanisms. In one of the bases, instead of steel gates similar to those in Hydra, it will be possible to activate protective lasers that will destroy everything living and non-living that touches them. To reach the boss, while approaching each base, part of the team will have to connect themselves to the said operator units to remotely control SEDs that are located near the boss, while the second part of the team will have to stay at the base to defend these units from attacks of Warface forces. That is remarkable, since it will be up to you to decide who and how many of you will fight the boss and who will stay to defend the base. In addition, to complete the stage most effectively, you will have to adequately distribute resources that will also play quite an important role in the mission. You will have to spend 1,000 resources accumulated while playing on the map to fly to the boss. You will also need them to defend the base from offensive Warface forces. Resources can be used to repair said link units connected to your friends who fight the boss and to acquire other great things. In particular, we have created a new amazing item, a portable turret. By using resources, you will be able to place it at the most favorable vantage point to defend the base from advancing Warface troops. The mission is set at a high difficulty level. That's why you can kill a teammate by a stray bullet. Moreover, beware of mines and fuel barrels. Checkpoints are few. We have also changed the basic enemy archetypes for Warface, including the helicopter and the armored personnel carrier. Your main goal will be to destroy three Warface bosses. It will be up to you to choose the order in which to eliminate them, as your reward will depend on the last boss annihilated. Each boss has three stages depending on the order in which players approach it. The first boss can teleport. You will have to capture and finish it with a special move. The boss is a new Oberon's robot prototype. At the first stage, you will be able to cope with the teleporting robot on your own. Later, a comrade's help will come in handy, as the boss will have a support team as well. At the final stage, you will have to monitor where the enemy is and how quickly you can reach it via teleportation platforms. The second boss is a laser one. It was specifically designed not as an enemy-based, but rather an environmental-based encounter. You will have to destroy an energy plant. However, after eliminating each block, the difficulty will rise. The first and second stages have the same layout, but are completed in a slightly different way since enemies are spawned in a different way. At first, the final stage presupposed close cooperation, but to preserve fun with random players, the level was simplified. Only the main cooperation elements remained. The following feature is an important mission element. After a player's SID is disabled, the fighter will be disconnected from the operator unit and can join the defenders of the base or reconnect to the robot. SIDs also use operator units. It is not a bug. In this case, the signal is redirected. The new reward system in the Blackwood operation depends on the time periods like in Hydra. Only the principle of reward gain has changed. In the Special Operation Hydra, you get boxes with rewards for the number of reached checkpoints, while in the new mission, you will get boxes for the last boss killed during a certain period of time. In total, you can get up to 3 boxes for 1 cycle. As for the lore, this special operation is one of the coolest and most dramatic missions that we have ever created. It is full of interesting plot twists, and it will end in an extremely unexpected way that I'm sure many of you will appreciate, especially those players who have been following the Warface story from the very beginning. It will be absolutely mind-blowing. We are looking forward to hearing your feedback on how the mission ends. We have created a large location and have boosted the environments to the full. We have added new enemies, new mechanics, new bosses, and the overall image has become very stylish and atmospheric. Moreover, we have introduced a new PvP map for the Storm mode. We have had tons of fun while designing it and conducting playtests. I am sure you will like it as much as we do. The southern coast of Iceland was chosen as the mission scenery. At first, the squad will be deployed among rocks bending around the Atlantic Ocean. Moving to the second capture point, you will find yourselves in an ice cave. Cold colors of the rocks create an impression that you are in the ice caves of Iceland. Against the bright blue colors, player readability will be excellent. You'll clearly see the enemy. The third capture point is a huge building, a hub from an already familiar mission. You will feel a cool breeze during hot firefights to capture the point.